This is Fresno's Past, a look at the pop culture environment of the city of Fresno from 1950 to 1990. And here is your host, Dale Mehl.
Thank you once again, Mark. On this program, we'll talk about a real incident about my brother and a KYNO contest. We'll label the month and year October 63. And the rest of it is all about the telephone, those Fresno local exchanges, the trouble with having a party line in the 50s, and finally a skit about my brother calling Kino and trying to give the correct answer about a question to try to win a copy of Wipeout by the Safaris. We start with exchanges on phone numbers. Do you remember what those are? Names of people that were used for the first two numbers of the telephone number. Example, Clinton was CL, and that was used for 255, CL5, blah, 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 blah. With the name Clinton and those two letters, you can get more phone numbers issued to customers. AT&T issued instructions in 1957 on how to use those exchange named numbers. I am still familiar with Amherst, AM, and Clinton, CL, but there was also Adams, AD, Axe Minister, AX, Baldwin, BA, and Cypress, CY. In 1961, local telephone numbers started to appear as straight digits, and the exchange names ended in Fresno in the late 60s. Okay, next is the party line. At least two people would be involved with the same phone number. Imagine today if you wanted to save money on your cell phone number, you could accept another person to share your number, like in the old days. It was a real pain in the evening hours. You could pick up the phone and hear another person on the other end. Yak, yak, yak. Maybe you wanted to call a family member or win a contest on a radio station, and the other person was on the line. And all you heard was yak, 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 yakety, yak, 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 yak from an old person. My family had a party line in the mid to late 50s, and you could tell the difference from the other person and us by the ringtone. Party lines were encouraged in the 1930s and 40s because copper wire was in short supply because of the Depression and also World War II. Nearly 75% of the residents in the United States used a party line in the 40s, and it pretty much ended around 1959. And now we're going to do a skit for you. Using a party line, pretending it's October 1963, and it's my brother trying to call KYNO Radio to win a copy of Wipeout by the Safaris. Now, the contest is real, so let's introduce the lovely Sydney.
Hi, I'm Sydney, and I'm glad to be here.
Thank you, Sydney. She will be playing Myrtle on the other end of a party line in October 63. I will be playing my brother trying to win a Kino contest. It's October 63. It's after 9 p.m., and Jay Loden is on the air at Kino and asking the all-important question, when did the instrumental Wipeout by the Safaris enter the Kino charts? My brother knew the answer. It was 463, April 1963. So he wants to go to the phone and call up the radio station. Myrtle is on the line, and parts of this story are true, just the contest. Myrtle is talking to Mildred, and the plot thickens. Oh, says Art, I know the answer to that kind of question about Wipeout. Just have to remember, it's 463. Remember, 463. Let's dial.
Now, I saw Bertha and Ethel at the Safeway, and they were both buying fresh grounded MJB coffee. And I said to Bertha,
hey, who's this?
This is Myrtle, and I'm talking with Mildred. How can I help you?
My mom stubbed her toe, and it's bleeding. And I need the phone to call an ambulance.
Mildred, I'll talk to you later. The other party line family needs the phone. Bye.
Now, let's dial up Kino and win Wipeout. 463. Okay, pick the phone. CL5 8383. Ah, rats. Got a busy signal. Let's try this again. All right, 255. No, CL58383.
Hi, 130 Kino, Jay Loden here. How can I help you?
Hi, the month and year is May of 1963. Did I win?
I'm sorry, that's the wrong answer.
What? Jay hung up on me. I don't like you anymore, Jay Loden. Wait a minute. I was thinking 463. Oh, that's April 63. Oh, caca! Anyway, my brother lost the contest, and April 63 was the correct answer. Information for this program was provided by Ask Me with Paula Lloyd from the Fresno Bee from an article in the paper from June 21st, 2014. Also, Wikipedia and my memories. And last but not least, my brother from 1963, a sophomore in high school, trying to win a 45 copy of Wipeout. Let's end the program with a crisp, clean, no caffeine copy of Wipeout. It's like 7-Up. You like it, it likes you. Talk to you later.